Here's an example of how to import a PCF file into Spool Fab to make an installation drawing and then split it into spools for fabrication. We go to File, Read IDF PCF file. I'll choose this file here. Now we're not showing the dimensions here and we're not showing the item tags. That's to just keep it less cluttered. I'm going to adjust the lengths of some of these pipes. So I'll go Control J and then Control right arrow and then up arrow to make this pipe import longer next time. These we can leave, make this a little bit longer, and this one. Over here, well, we can make these longer as well. Oh, I happen to know that this is a 60-foot long pipe, so I'm going to make it quite a bit longer. These upper ones we can leave. These we should make longer as well, so that's up arrow, then control right, up arrow again, control right. I'm going to make these longer, get this up out of the way here. Now I'm going to press enter, and it's pretty well okay. Yes, that'll work. Now, let's save that. So we go File, Save As, and we'll make it control number 6 in this case. Doesn't matter. Okay, now, so we have our drawing. We're going to split it into spools. Just a moment. Let's just look at the dimensions first. So we show all dimensions. We know this is 60 feet. That's rather a lot, perhaps, for a spool drawing. So let's just split that spool there. We'll go subdivide pipe, and we'll make this side of it, let's make it 35 feet. And then we'll split it here in the middle later on. Now I'm going to hide the dimensions again. Okay, now to split this into spools, we would probably want to put some extra breakpoints here. We have to break it there because this is just too long to transport. So I'm just going to make the decision that we're going to put breakpoints here and here. We'll not add trim for the moment. So to do that, I went to Tools, Add or Remove Breakpoints, and then I placed the breakpoint at the appropriate spot. Now I'm going to resave the drawing so that it doesn't force me to do that. Then we go File, Split into Spools, and you'll see it's decided that it's going to call this part down here, this highlighted in blue, this is going to be spool A, and then it reckons that's spool B, C, D. Actually, let's make spool D, let's move spool D up so that it becomes next to spool A. So I'm going to move it up, and then I'm now going to move E up so it becomes spool C. So now we have A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Okay, so let's save them then in order. Doesn't have to be in order, but we'll do them A, B, C, D, E anyway. So we hit spool A, save spool. It calls it by default 6A. And we'll just leave it at 6A. Then we go spool B, save spool 6B, spool C, save spool 6C, spool D, save spool 6D. We'll be making these bigger later on. Here's E, F, and G. Okay, then we hit resume and everything's back here. Now we'd like to label it so that we know which spool came from where. So let's go dimension, show item tags. You'll see the reason for that in a moment. Then we go tools, label item, add control number label, and we click on these spools. Now I know this is spool A, so I hit here control number 6A, and then this one is 6B, and up here we have 6C, and then I think this one is D, I think. It knows, if you get this out of order, here I'll do one deliberately out of order so you can see that it actually knows which is which here. And this one is G, and we can do this one E. And if you accidentally do one of them twice, it'll just have a label twice. That was D, like for example here, this one's also D. I'll just press escape, we don't need that. So now we have A, B, C, D, D again, and then E, F, and G. I'll just refresh the screen here. Perhaps I'll just take this one off. Okay. That's okay. Good. Okay, let's go and look at the fabrication drawings that we produced. We'll go file. I'm going to make a list here so we can go through them quickly. The ones we did were 6A through G, so there's the list. And if I go page down, we'll go through the 7 drawings that we made here. Now you'll notice they're small, but we can fix that quite easily. Now the next thing we do is, usually the next thing you do is to make a batch operation to resave the drawings and make them bigger. And I'll make them bigger by extra 40%. And we also show the weld map. So we proceed with that for the 7 drawings. Just watch it happen here. Okay, it's processed the 7 drawings. Now, we could make this one bigger yet because it's really smaller than it needs to be. Increase it by that. Now, here you can see the weld tags. This is a weld tag. This is an item tag. And I can just adjust these to suit. Those are different butt welds. This is basically, we're finished here with this one. We've got the bill of materials and we've got the weld list. It's quite a simple drawing, of course. So I'll just resave that. That was G, 6G. Now I press the page up and I get to 6F. This is basically the same sort of thing. I just have to reorganize these weld tags a little. Oh, I suppose we should be looking at the dimensions a little as well, but that's simple enough. We'll do that in a moment when I get these sorted out. Okay, let's turn on the dimensions. Okay, now we might need to reposition some of these, so I'll just do that. This one would be better down here a little bit. This one I'll move out. We should probably put some dimensions on this offset box here, so I'll go dimension, offset box, and I'll put a dimension over here and another one up here. They're the same number, so of course it shows it's 45 degrees. Okay, and Might need to move some of these tags a little. This dimension here isn't really necessary, of course, because it's a fitting dimension. We can show that or not. If you can, let's right click on one of the arrows here and it'll make it disappear. Okay, that's good. So we're finished with this one. File, resave. Then I'll go page up to go to 6E. Well, it's pretty simple as well. So we'll go F9, drag the weld tag a bit, and drag the item tag here and the weld tag. Escape to get out of that mode. Tools, scale drawing by 140%, and that's legible. File, resave. Page up to go to the next one. F9, and I'll just reposition the ones that I need to. Okay. This one here. Oh, that's the item tag, and this is the weld tag. And let's make this one a bit bigger as well. Scale drawing by, let's say, 130. And we should show the dimensions, I suppose. We might have to move some of those. Let's put this one over here. Gets it out of the way. This one a little higher up, because you can see here the cut length was interfering with this corner of the offset box. So we just move that out of the way. Maybe bring this down a little. Okay, we're good there. File, resave. And then page up. And this one doesn't need very much in the way of organizing. I'll just move them as needed here. Let's show the dimensions. And I'll move this one over a little. And 35 feet, that's okay. Yeah, and we don't really need this 9 3/4. So I'll just opt not to show those. You can bring them back whenever you want by going show all dimensions, but not much point in cluttering it up. Okay, that's this one done. File, resave. That was C. Page up, we go to B. Oh, this is a pretty simple one. Don't even have to reorient anything. We've got our dimensions on here. That's fine. File, oh, let's make it a bit bigger. Scale drawing by 140. You can actually put in whatever percentage you want. Let's make it 160. Okay, and then file, resave, page up. And now this is A. We should probably click on here and go break pipe and draw break over to there. That makes it easier to see what's going on. Let's put the dimensions on. Show all dimensions. Oh yes, we'll need to organize these a little. 3'9". Well, let's just move this one up out of the way for the moment. This one is 3'9½, this one. So these two are equal. So some people like to make equal things look equal. So let's grab that weld neck flange and just move it up there. Press enter. So it's about the same as the other one. Be less confusing. And let's move this down to here. That will also be less confusing. And we'll move this one over to here. All right. And are there any item tags or weld tags we need to move? Maybe not. See, the if the drawing is not so crowded, then you tend not to have to move things much. Okay, that's good. So that's file, resave. And so here are the various spools then. This is spool A, spool B, C, D, E, F, and G. And actually, I should go back to spools then. A, B, and C were all joined together, right? So let's see now. If this one had been trim, suppose we hit this and we say joint trim, then you'll notice that that changed this to clean end, because there's not much point in beveling it if you're going to use field trim. So we'll go file, resave. So now, to sum up, we've got 7 drawings we made from a single PCF file, and we also have an installation drawing that'll show us where to, which will be a big help in the field when we're installing all these, and we know how the various spools go together because we have this, it's all listed on here. So this has been how to import a PCF and split it into 7 fabrication spools. Thank you for watching.